It's fun and vulgar, and that's just me.
This is the third and last process to text reading for this semester. Look for us for three more in the spring. We've got two great writers tonight, Cynthia Manick and Adam to Gusto. We can read a little bit, and then we'll gather up here and we can ask them some questions about the process. Let me tell you a little bit about Cynthia Manick. Cynthia is the author of Blue Hallelujahs. She is a Pushcart Prize nominee.
We'll start with a little passage. The ancestors of the little black girls. All I want is rain. All I want is rain and air and sleep and air and water. All I want is water. Water in my mouth like a rope bruise. Water counting on my eyelids like the purest waterfall. All I want is a waterfall to fall to pieces, to fall to clouds where my mother and father sleep, to fall from lakes, a graceful sleep where all I need is air. On these airs make me fly, to drop me in the sea. All I want is the sea, life has some breasts pulling me like a sudden need or still in a ship, taking me anywhere. Pulling me nowhere, all I really want is to go home. So this next poem I actually wrote because someone admired the gap between my teeth. You said, how you want them to like it? What do you mean? Yeah, I'm getting freshly done. I was like, don't get a gap professionally put in. That's when it could use to me instead. This poem is called Mind the Gap. Little Eve wants a smile like mine. Teeth with a gap so wide, a corn husk and tugboat could pull through. Or a submarine, lost sounds and grunts. Tiny light bulbs, if you're careful, or a string of Christmas lights blew through light front. Does she know how the world works? How some of us are born without 40 acres in the weight of a mule on their chest? Like my mother and Monday mornings, or in the F train, in two buses, with two children, her own Negro carrying. A sonata full of love, low walk clinics, and her vowels like swords. How I often waited in those long-ass lines, and choose what haunts us. When I was young, I played closed spaces, bright veneers, the smog of a rude comfortable, when bad days would show the temple. No one notices the mouth and Bojangles is dancing. So this next poem, I actually wrote it at a residency in Georgia, where they instantly shot the deliverance. I did not know that before I arrived. The captain briefly told me this in the car right there. And one was like, you know, I feel like, you know, I want to kill something. So I'm from Brooklyn. I follow up. So what do you mean? She's like, oh, you know, I want to skin my own deer and make it die. I said, no. Just no. No. Well, just really, what would it happen at? You're going to listen to you. You can hear your captain. So that's fire. It's a very good what lies with you? Today, I'm elbow deep in some animal's belly, pulling out the heart and stomach from my mother's table, brown are the soles, blood slit, the swinging from blades, cuts a whole village, broke a coon, carved bones for ladies, jewelry and coats. These hands can ground down rock and gold, call a man sweet dusty, will not suspect in hair, like clay, until the baby's head is perfectly crowned. These hands are good for killing. I feel this moan rise, like different names for fire. Every bone has a ghost, the smallest, a stirp in the air whispers, walk carefully there, you know you come from a dark tribe. These Mexican poems are for my grandparents. They're very different from each other, but it's why I think it worked. This first poem is called Pulling Threads. My mother's mother is a doll not yet painted. Too light to be brown, too dark to be white, a beige red cap not in the rainbow. You need to put that doll in fire, people would say. All the time is wondering why she married Grandma Lily, that slick on the pearl, who pulled bushels of oysters from the sea. They court her, throw her fine brown strands of hand, bring jars of buttery for fortunes, 10 basins of crabs and coconuts, soap carvings of walrus and snails, or did they crawl into frolic sounds as he laid her down and baked her skin in the sun. Yesterday, I found a photograph in the upstairs dresser. Her white, well-worn corset, pink gloves that lace at the elbow. This palmy hair slipped to the right, the juice drips by, gold-paved incantations of baby, baby, and the bark of bodies bursting like bones. It takes time now to see past their layers. Their savvy nets are just a quarter full, corrosion of apple seeds. Her hands do that slow, shaky thing that almost remains like water leaves, climbing up the throat, trying to find the heat and stirring the vital burners. And also that my grandpa was actually very, very quiet, unless he had a dream. When he's quiet, he's very talking about bravery and how you will overcome. He was very, involved in at times. King of the natural world. Who knows but back on the lower frequencies, the patterns and the rain. The ripe break of a herringbone, or the egg, the root and worm, spoon fed into tree skin. Grandpa knows how to build up the gorges, tall enough to see trouble coming. The way the palm curves to the right for the perfect bird call. Hammer or alder wood that brings black bands. How to roast bumblebee husks in April. Stew crocodile underbelly with lamprey so it seeps from the mouth like sap. He knows the first taste of grief rattles the teeth like a deep content of family. And slams the old body to the belly as well. This next poem, I don't read that often, but it's being translated into French right now, and it's kind of freaking me out. Because the way the French do like verbs and stuff, it's really just odd. So I'm going to read this poem that's in my mind right now. And you know, I think we all have two selves, the self you show people, and the self at home where you're watching like documentary on like how to make carousel or being vaccinated. I won't talk about that, but it fascinates me. Three for envy. Think of the way doctors compact a body. Primary colors and cold metal join just right. This is not the star I show. My love for surgery porn at 1 a.m. Orthopedic surgeons that re-break bones and muscle clearing. Heaven is the sound of tiny mallets, but a heart was calling on top of each other, like those Asian boys who fell through the cracks in the earth. So fast that even gravity was surprised. Tiny galaxies formed in their mouths, a gathering of tongues, souls, and rubble, dirt that says, I eat you to live. I question those souls and statues. Do you shake the sense of death from the skull like a woman's shawl? Or does it rest in the crease of hands and that space between sock and ankle? I want to be the animal that roots the ground, the peaches, bones, and stars. Are we okay?
We're good.
Okay, I'm checking. This next poem was a letter, no, sign actually. I read a letter to my 13-year-old self. It's called Letter to 1991. You're 13 now, and Dad still calls you Snow, a nickname you crave to shake loose like pimples and oatmeal cream little fairy cakes. You worry too much. You worry about Mom and Dad, the music of something bringing its red lip lights all the way sometimes. Put your head in a book of sand. Bring a little brother in the back room and close the door. There's a suitcase full of hurt there. And no, you can't unpack it. Think of that summer when you were six and your foot slipped into a house of red pants. The biting of your right leg, the stings and the buzzing. I'm hoping to play dead, like a possum. I filled it with alcohol, dripped down, dark as blood. The insects fell one by one, dead little bodies all over the place. Mama held you next to the fullness of her thighs. You didn't cry. No hauling or heaving, take hold of that memory now. Rub it between your fingers. The secret of living in this body is time. And all the worry is like walking backwards on the track. Think I don't know you? Your favorite word is affirmation, because of the way consonants and vowels curl along the tongue. This is the time when you should only dream dreams. But now you should know that sometimes you have to write in order to figure out what you can never say. Let's go a little bit lighter. Dear black dress. So we all have this dress you wear, you go out, it's boom, 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 you're ready to get in trouble. You all have it. Dear black dress. Don't speak to me. Don't speak to me about the hot haze that keeps you up past midnight. The groove held tight in your double stitch in the seam. And Carmen's men like blooming jasmine, its scent swells the mouth. The triangle sends two quarters down to stop the silhouette. Shine the light on legs, a well-lit street to a body of currents. I'm not immune to your sorcery, the sweet feed of darkness, the way damp air travels from cotton to skin to mind. You will dance all the shadows that go. swallow octaves, cut through, horses and lungs, and hips. I tried to calm you, sedate you with pink cardigans and baby brown shawls, but it's like covering some pump by my knife deep on the crowd. No marrow is ever safe. Now sometimes I write lyrics into music, and so I do one poem a tribute to jazz. Staccato envy, the revolution. 1,000 saxophones infiltrate the city, two by two each with a pulse of its own. Some have bodies big as elephant ears and heavy lit missiles that shoot from their pitch. Others take the long way down, so crandles drop octaves along the banks, making concrete grooves settle with a click. Bylones and cypress leaves. They leave behind geese girls in the grass, monstrous girls bowing yes, yes. The altos want to turn New Orleans red. Play summertime in the streets. Have a gulp in civilians like ribs swamped and barbecue. Liberate bodies from inside out. They're all one night in full. Three breeds on every corner, every concert hall. I get settled like gold dust from clip to clavicle. Walking from the city into a Panama of sound, a house of blues, till it swells like an open mouth, and the babies are scattered in their sleep. So I had a dream a couple years ago where I didn't have any skin. I know it sounds crazy, but in the dream, like no one had any skin, so I was communing with skinless people, so I didn't feel like I was alone. The future of skin. In every dream, I wear a different armor. In one, I'm a wolf, and no one sees me coming. I keep the wildness at bay, the bristles from my teeth, knowing I've split arrows and femurs like shea butter. In another, I'm a rooster with silver claws. I have premonitions of eclipses of salt, crusted waters, pulling me like tiny charges to new tribes. Nothing burns, screams, or crows an alarm. Or I'm a simple skeleton, free from skin sweat. Air small and dense, and eyes locked slack, a painter's cold with a riot inside. I step out in the sun and see skeletons everywhere. Purses tucked under bone, sharp blades. My feet are bare too, just little tarsals and toe rings. But it's so warm with the skin, nowhere to be found. Crosses, nowhere to be found. The noose, nowhere to be found. So if you have moments where you realize your parents are people, it comes unexpectedly. You can hear a child like, oh wait, they have their own problems besides no reason. This one is called New York NTA Exam, Attempt Number 4. One night I hear my father's voice shaking out. If you want to feel our evaluation of your employment history, back his tongue or magpies needing to be trained. When I step in the kitchen, he turns to smiling movie, but there are no black fathers. Later I discover he takes an exam a fifth, sixth, and eighth time. Under supervision, pre-care, track, and road. Until muzzled, he simply stopped, thrashing on the hook, trying to swim upstream to pay with a little something left over. And I learned to hide. I hide my shimmer, I forget spelling bees, stars, sticker reading charts, and tests for smiles, thinking them master tools to be only used in secret. Ah, She harassed me. I'm really small phone about it. Baby, what's your favorite body part? I get that all the time in Brooklyn. First of all, who your homies? Where are we gonna go? And secondly, this for you. Baby, what's your favorite body part? A blue collar man asked, with his mouth shaped like a creature's, gaze the size of wishes. And part of my rib cuts open, and something heavier than a sequoia tree settles. Gone is my fastest Josephine Baker dental, my Aladdin sweater, I'm a bolero singer, off the Mingo star. I can damn like a buttered biscuit, I wish he'd be mine. Who knows how not to blossom? Be well aimed lightly to a sweaty mist. Hit like a dark flame, the feminine flame who hugs you just a little too tight. Those who say why when you are silent, I want these dancing legs full from a room to know when to speak, to run, be purple bitter, shine, clone. I wish those with the sisters named Caroline, Mary, daughters called Princess, walking alone and voices in the dark. I'm going to do two more. So if you have not seen Luke Cage, it's your life. You surely want to. It's great. Show on Marvel. This poem is called Praise for Luke Cage's Skin and Starshine. You know what it's like to be night all the time, don't you? Others have to wait for that artificial glow for your backlight or camera booth, but you are an element that can't be splashed or quantified. I like being bulletproof and free. You make wanting to live a life legal where eyes can stay wide, hungry, and not sad. Anywhere you go, black boys follow. Try to scoop yourselves and selves and left behind. Some have tiny magnifying glasses and mini plastic cups. And when something is found, they watch it like seeds ready to sprout wings or leaves of comic book power. Others take their loot, rub it along their hairline and edges like it's part pommy, part starshine. And I resist the urge to join with you because those light-skinned boys keep their love too far from my skin's reach. Your cage would have me moon-wrapped, wondering how a rooster moons, if my own father was what I was beautiful. We'd walk through Harlem, you in a fitted suit, and me wearing well anything I did will be. That's what made a movie magic turns us into one body, the right shade of burning mac black. So I'm going to end on the first poem in Halloween, and it's called What I Know About Blues. What I Know About Blues. I know butterflies can taste with their feet. Blackberry vinegar or apple water can break the fever. I know the sharp glint of my mother's tongue, use every part of the fruit and stem, she'd say, don't leave anything behind. I know the skin of mackerel is softer than an island. I know salt, gray sips through sips, calling on the mice black, like gold. Can you feel my hold of breath inside? Use my body to say, I can be a clementine, I can be your sweet baby. Yes. I know how to read names. I've been called Little Baby, Piccadilly, Dell, Thomasita, the Black One, the Big One, the Dark One, Woman, each name may be.